Hey, how y'all doing? Today is Wednesday, September 17th, 2008. My name is Michelle Williams. I present myself to some and introduce to others. Welcome back to Michelle Williams TV. I'm going to open up with the greatest. Take a listen.
Thought I was standing tall, I thought I'd seen it all, but baby, I was wrong, 'cause you're the greatest. I walked 1,000 miles, but nothing's what I found, until you came around. Cause you're the greatest. Searched high and low for love just to find out that it was here.
Baby, you're the greatest. Thank you to Rico Love for writing such a beautiful song and to Jim Johnson for producing this beautiful track. I'm filming the video next week, the 24th, here in LA. My favorite part.
And I cannot believe that I was searching so long.
Tell you something, that song really makes my spirit happy. I feel like I just think about all the great things in my life that have happened to me the past 9 years of my life, the awesome people that God has placed in my life, and the angels that I know that are coming into my life. Makes me have such a better day today. Anyway, how are y'all doing? I know I've been away for a very long time on the video blogs. I call myself trying to do these kite things, which I'm very excited about. It's where you can actually broadcast live from wherever you are and upload it to my MySpace page. So thank you to Jay Fisher for that, giving you a shout out for my kite player, my kite phone. I appreciate you for that. Anywho, I want to start off by saying I want you guys to respond to me with a question that I have about. There is a line in the song The Greatest, and it says, And I was reaching for the stars, but I didn't have to look so far because love's where you are. And I feel like sometimes we look so far for love, or we look in places that we have no business looking in, and sometimes love could be, you know, that best friend that you've always had for years, or he's not going to be, you know, let's just face it, everybody ain't going to marry a millionaire. Everybody's not going to marry a high-powered attorney. Everybody ain't going to marry a fabulous Wall Street broker. It's not going to happen to everybody, although it would be nice. But what if the great is for you? What if that man is a supervisor, you know, for a parcel shipping service? You know, what if he's the actual delivery man? Baby, wouldn't it be crazy if your husband showed up at your doorstep delivering a box to you or something, and you look at him like, ooh. Or he looks at you like, ooh, hey, wow. Why do we always look for love in the craziest places? Why do we think that, you know, we look at what other people have and think that that's what we're supposed to have too, as far as especially love or someone else's career? And I feel you should never want what somebody else has, because you don't know the struggle that it took for them to get there. I didn't mean to go there, but I just want to know. My question is, who is the greatest for you? Who makes you feel like you can fly? Who makes you feel like you can love again? What is the greatest for you? You know, even the greatest, did someone help you succeed in college? I know some of my most loyal fans have entered their first year of college. You know, who's the greatest for you? You know, who's graduated from school? You know, when you didn't think that you were going to make it. Did somebody just, you know, guide you through that? To me, that's the greatest. To me, the ultimate greatest for me is God. You know what I'm saying? So I didn't mean to get all deep and heavy my first blog back, but I definitely want to know. So respond to me, and in my next blog, I will respond back to you. We'll have like a greatest debate, a Michelle Williams campaign debate about love and the greatest things in your life. All right? So you can also pick up The Greatest. It's on iTunes. I'm so happy. I love my artwork, the album cover for The Greatest single, and Hello Heartbreak is out as well on iTunes. Okie dokie. So October 7th, the album will still be in stores. A lot of people, you know, everyone's saying they're concerned, but you know what? We are going to be just fine. This album has so much life to it. I want the next 12 months to just be spectacular. You know, like I said, this album, we could be touring and gigging off these songs for a long time. So I'm not looking to do just crazy, stupid, you know, right off the bat. I want to build. I want a story to tell about this. You know what I'm saying? The past 8 years of my life, the past 9 years have been just an unexpected journey, and just, you know, so I wanted to share that with y'all through my music. All right, so anywho, I love you so very much, and I cut my hair in the back. It's really short. It's real cute. And on this side is some pieces that can hang, you know. We kind of left this just to remind me that I do have hair. But I figured, hey, I always wanted to have short hair, you know. So I've never had short hair in my life. I think when I was 16, I had a bob, but it was like, it grew right back out. So anywho, next year we'll see. Maybe I'll grow my hair back out. But I love the spunkiness that it gives me. It makes me feel, you know, gives me a, I don't know, a different type of vibe. And I'm loving it. You know what I'm saying? So I'm much more free. Freer. Is that a word? I'm sure somebody will let me know that it ain't a word. Anywho, y'all have a good day, and I will see you soon, all right? I love you.
'cause you always shine. Baby, you're